Isaiah 1, verse 18, it says, come now. Ain't that what we've been preaching about, the wise men did? Come now. Somebody say, now's the time. That's right. Today's the day of salvation, 2 Corinthians 6, 2. Hebrews 3, 7, wherefore today if you hear the voice of the Holy Ghost, somebody say, now's the time. You know, the word present don't only mean a gift, but the word present also is a statement of time, intermediately between the past and the future, called now, the present. Somebody said, that's the only present we have, is now. Come now. Isaiah 1:18 says, somebody say, come now. If you're watching, now's the time. Don't put him off. Tomorrow may be too late. Yesterday's history, tomorrow's a mystery, but today's the gift of God. That's why we call it the present. Right now. Somebody say, the present is the present. My God, that's the gift of now. The now gift. Hallelujah. So listen what Isaiah prophesies here. And just keep backing that up. So we just got music. Come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. And though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. Somebody say, let us reason together. Now right up here on the remembrance table, it says, Jesus, the reason for the season. You heard Dylan mention that. How many still say that, but it's just become a religious cliche that he's the reason for the season. But really, he's become, you know, one of the reasons, the many reasons for the season, instead of the only reason. But somebody say, this is also a season to reason. Because right here, Isaiah says, your sins may be like scarlet. That means red like crimson. And then he just goes on and says, red like crimson. He said, it can be whiter than snow. It can be as wool. Wool's white. Somebody say, a white Christmas. Yeah. You don't got a dream for it. You can have it. Jesus said, your sins may be red like crimson, but they can be whiter than snow. He said, come now and let us reason together, saith the Lord. The word reason, listen to this, reason means to even argue. The word reason means to chasten. It means to convince. It even means to correct or even dispute with somebody. Reason literally means to judge in righteousness, to plead, even to rebuke and reprove. But mostly what the word reason means in Isaiah 1:18, come now, let us reason together, saith the Lord. Come now and let us reason together. It literally means to convict and convince. God says, let me convince you. And yes, let me convict. Somebody say, which means to open the eye. The word conviction means to open the eye. You can't open your heart to God until your eye gets open, until the blinders come off. And he says, though your sins be red as scarlet, they can be whiter as snow. God is saying, this is the season to reason. Somebody say, about the sin in my life and about the Savior that came and was born of a virgin and was crucified on the cross and raised from the dead so my sins could be made whiter than snow. Somebody say, it's the season to reason. Not a season to fight with God and fuss with God and dispute with God. The dispute is settled at the cross. We've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23, and we need a Savior. Somebody say, be convinced. Somebody say, have a convincing Christmas. Have a convicting Christmas. Hallelujah. Because only then can we have a converted Christmas. And notice what he warns, though. Here's the conviction of the message in Isaiah 1. That's verse 18. Verse 19, he said, if you're willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. But verse 20, hear the warning. But if you refuse and rebel, you shall be devoured by the sword, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken it. Somebody say, this is a gift called eternal life, but it's also a gift called escape. It's a gift of escape, because Hebrews 2:3 said, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? Somebody say, this is a gift of eternal life, but it's a gift of escape from eternal damnation, because there's another side to eternity. There's a hell. Some people won't be home for Christmas. Brother J.D. Simpson, that sit right there, December the 8th, he left this world. He won't be in church no more, but he's been in heaven ever since. Amen. Brother J.D. is in heaven for Christmas. Some of you know somebody, loved ones, they're in heaven for Christmas because they believed on Jesus here, and now they're with him forever. But sadly, somebody will be in hell for Christmas for the rest of eternity because they didn't give their life to the one that gave his life for them. Somebody say, Jesus stood between us and hell, and he hung on a cross, and it's our choice. I'm telling you, Christmas is so glorious. It is so eternal in value. That's why I don't compromise anything the world does in association with it. If y'all watched social media, Facebook, TV this morning, you probably saw me at about 8 a.m. in front of a store locally, and it had Merry Grinchmas over the door. I turned my back to it and I recorded, and I quoted John 1:14, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. We beheld his glory, the only begotten of God the Father, full of grace and truth. That's a Christmas scripture right there. Jesus became flesh, born of a virgin. And yet, we've seen through years, they say Xmas, take Christ out of it. Christ is being removed everywhere. And I thought, that ain't funny. And what's so sad, it'll be people that say they believe in Jesus that promote these things and put these things, because they just think it's fine. Hello? Anybody here holy? No, it is not just fun. This ain't child's play. Can I go ahead and offend somebody, since I'm at it? I usually will anyhow. Somebody say, Christmas is not a children's holiday. It's a holy child's holy day. Acts 4:27-30 calls Jesus the holy child Jesus. Somebody say, the holy child. Well, Brother Marvin, you know it's all about the children. No, it's not. That's what's wrong. Do you realize that's why it's commercialized? Well, it's all about the children. No, it's not. It's all about the child. It ain't about my children and your children. I'm not telling you don't bless your children in this time, but tell them where they got what they got from Jesus. The Savior Jesus, not some dead saint named Nick. Come on, anybody here, Holy Ghost? A child was born. A son was given, Isaiah 9:6. Somebody to say, this is not a children's holiday. It's a holy child's birthday celebration. It's a holy day. Somebody saying, if it's not a holy day, and if it's just a holiday, well, then it's a hollow day. It's empty of Christ. And I'll go ahead and tell you, this is the season to reason. He's not only the reason for the season, but this is the season to reason. And reason also means to rebuke, chasten, correct, and judge. So when I see stuff like that in Walmart, it's looking a lot like Christmas, and I can't find him nowhere. And I see songs written with Santa Claus on it, and it says Noel, which is a French word we've adopted in the English language, that's a song that literally means the nativity, the birth of Christ Jesus. And all you see is Saint Nick, not a Savior Jesus. I'm going to rebuke, I'm going to correct, I'm going to chasten, I'm going to speak out against. When it says Merry Grinchmas, I'm going to speak out against. People say, you just taking it too far. Thank you. The wise men just took it too far. In Matthew 2, they just took him too far. They just took it too far. They traveled far from the east to come worship him. I take worshiping him, I take it to the extreme. You right. I'll take it the distance. Hello? Because it offends the spirit of Christmas, the Holy Ghost inside of me, when people are just commercializing it. Well, brother, you know, some would argue, well, you know, when we're not Christians, where we're not, well, that's fine, that's okay, but I'm still going to preach Christ. I'll have people offended at me, not because I preach Christ, but because I preach only Christ at this season. They'll get offended at me, and it's amazing, they'll stand up for old Santy. Come on. Oh, Saint Nick, they'll stand up for him and defend him, but you can't find them when it's time to stand up for Jesus. Stand up for Santa, but not the Savior. I ain't trying to keep Christ in Christmas. I'm keeping Christ as Christmas. He's not only the reason for the season, but this is the season of the reason. And again, in Isaiah 1 and 8, that word reason literally means to sometimes argue, chasten, convince, correct, dispute, judge, plead, even rebuke and reprove to bring conviction. Hello? No, the masses ain't going to believe in Christ's mass. But if I can get one, Brother Danny, if one can get convinced, if one can get convicted, it's the season to reason. Not only is Jesus the reason for the season, but this is the season to reason. And usually I'm chastising those who say that. Like Dylan's poem said, that the Holy Ghost gave him. Wasn't that powerful? I'm going to read that part again right here. Here's where I broke yesterday. It says, the enemy steals, kills, and destroys. But this gift can't be played with like a toy. Man, I just couldn't have it. And he said, you say it's just fun, harmless fairy tale. I hear him say it all the time. But for me, it's a lie straight from hell. Jesus is the reason for the season? Yes, so they all say. But really, he is just one of the many reasons. And for me, that's not okay. Whew. Amen. I have lost more people, I didn't say friends, on social media this month, probably somewhere in the 40-ish, over this very, very, fairy fable. You'd have thought they'd have liked the parts I was preaching about Jesus. They had nothing to say about that, which is the absolute truth of the gospel that's written. All they could focus on is the reasoning, the chastening, and the reproof and the rebuke, the reason that I would call all the fables out on. Hallelujah. That's okay. Though none go with me, Jesus I follow. I got a friend in Jesus. Oh, what a wonderful child. Hallelujah. Somebody say the Christmas gift. Give you to Christ. There it is. It was the scriptures we was using. That's from a couple years ago. I put that up there because I used to have this little Christmas box. I've had it since the church has been started a little over 5 years, and I could not find it this year. And I thought, well, I may not find the box, but I know I got it on screenshot or snapshot, something or other. And so I found it, and so there it is. Hallelujah. Amen. That's from probably a couple of years ago. Amen. But that's what he wants, and that's what the bow's about. That's what Dylan's poem was about. Amen. And pray for Dylan. He'll be back next Sunday. He'll fly back in next Sunday. He'll probably be here next Sunday night. Amen. But God was using him last night, and God's used him while he's been there. Man, what a poem. Now I know y'all heard it in 4 minutes and 17 seconds, but there it is, 1.5 pages. He's kin to me. Happy birthday, Jesus. Let's just sing it one more time before we leave. I'm so glad it's Christmas. All the tinsel and lights and the presents are nice, but the real gift is you. It's all about you. Tell him happy birthday, Jesus. Merry Christmas. Jesus, I love you. Stay around, fellowship with one another. Stay in the altars, pray for one another. I'm so glad. Let the music keep playing. God bless you. Merry Christmas. And don't forget, Mary had Christmas. In the Savior name, Jesus. Somebody say, not a saint called.